I'm Anna Brown Ellers, and I was born and raised in Juneau, Alaska. Being the capital of the state of Alaska, there's a lot of government work. I worked for the Department of Health and Social Services.
This mild-mannered civil servant has a secret. 53 years ago, she had a terrifying encounter that defies explanation to this day.
I've never really talked about this in public before, just because I didn't want people to think differently of me, I guess. One time, my twin sister, my younger sister Diana, and my brother Austin were walking down to our grandma's house. I was 12 years old. In the wintertime, it gets so dark, we can see all the stars. And we have northern lights. And we're always outside in the wintertime looking up at the sky. And when we were on the overpass, we saw some lights in the sky that were not stars.
Even more alarming, those lights were getting closer.
And something came down from the sky that was bigger than a plane. What we saw was really big and unhumanly bright. It was brighter than the moon. But we were riveted. We couldn't take our eyes off of it. We didn't even talk to each other while it was happening. There was a light that was about a quarter the size of the moon that circled like it was taking pictures of Juneau and then flew off again, and it was totally silent. Wasn't anything that I could even imagine existed. We were dumbfounded. We didn't feel the cold, we didn't feel the snow, our feet were getting wet and everything. We didn't feel it though. I was never so dumbstruck in my life. It's never happened before or since.
For decades, Anna and her siblings kept quiet about what they'd seen for fear of being ridiculed.
My sisters and my brother, we never talked about the experience for several days. And we were afraid to tell our parents because we didn't think they'd believe us. The reason I'm willing to talk on camera about what happened is because now I feel more likely to be believed. Even military men are talking about having seen UFOs while they're flying, and there's more people documented nationwide that entire towns have seen UFOs. I believe that the vision that we saw was not of this earth, because it was so huge and it was hovering and it was so quiet. Whatever was operating that vehicle had to be very powerful, and if it wanted to do harm to our people, it could have.
Anna is thankful that the alien entity from that night did her no harm, but the memories still affect her to this day as she keeps her gaze skyward on the lookout for a return visit. About 45 years before Nick Pavlik's bizarre sighting, his dad had a frightening encounter of his own.
I'm John Pavlik, live in Yakutat, Alaska. And I seen something scary. I was visited by some big UFO.
John is well known in this corner of the state, legendary for his hunting skills.
Started as a young kid, hunting seal, and then I'd go trapping for rabbits, marten, wolverine, foxes. I learned that you can make a living just putting down the food that grows wild here, but there's some real danger. No matter how good you are, you get caught in unexpected situations.
Taking on the wilds of the Alaskan bush is one thing. What John experienced that fateful night was something beyond human comprehension.
one of the strangest trips is when we experienced some kind of UFO.
John and a handful of other men were on an extended seal hunting expedition on the unforgiving coastline outside of Yakutat.
It was dark and we had 28 seal down. Well, I keep a pretty alert because it's very important, you know. Something showed up on us. Some kind of an aircraft hovered over us. It's a big spaceship of some type. Big as a football field. It showed up on us and it started bouncing fireballs. At least 1,000 small flying saucers came out of it. It looked like the stars in the sky turned into small flying saucers. They darted around up in front of us while the super big one come up behind us. And they had fireballs going everywhere.
John couldn't make sense of what was happening. It seemed his hunting party had just become prey.
I just knew that this is serious. I told the guys, I said, well, load up. This didn't look good for us. They just like, what are you gonna do with guns? I said, we're gonna fight. We're gonna do what we have to do, you know? Let's aim our guns and see. And we aimed our guns at them. We had a 30-06 and a 22-50 and a 222 Remington Magnum. I was aiming right into the window area because I wanted it to penetrate it. And I could make out some kind of a frame. But they took off, disappeared, without making one bit of noise. So we tied up our skins and went to bed.
The hunters were incredibly relieved to make it back to their cabin. John had no idea his ordeal was just getting started. He was asleep in his cabin, trying to put his UFO sighting behind him when he was awakened by something not of this world.
At night, at 3 a.m, the door opened by itself. It kind of like hypnotized me. I couldn't move it. You couldn't get your strength to grab your gun or nothing. I couldn't see, but I realized I was in danger. And then I realized they were trying to levitate me out of my bunk with some kind of power, magic or magnets or whatever they use to pull a body up. I felt the nails starting to rip away from the wall, 2x4s. I thought they were going to take my whole body and all, so I just bolted myself to the bed. Whatever they wanted to do with me, wanted me bad. I wasn't going to let them get me, tell you that. So I figured, boy, I'm just going to shoot and jump right in the ocean. Hope I make it. I don't even know how to swim, you know. I managed to put the gun up over my shoulders and aim. But then, I could hear the voice. They said, we just can't take this one. He won't let go. He's too tough. So that was it. They took off. They couldn't get me. And I never seen him again.
But that doesn't mean he isn't still looking over his shoulder.
It was a very strange and very scary situation. What I seen explains we've been visited. We're out there where they can get at us. If they're trying to get information from humans, they can have more chances of just somebody out in a campsite hunting than they would have in a big city. And that's probably how people are getting disappeared in Alaska. So I don't think we're alone in the universe.
Why there are so many UFO sightings and so many disappearances remains a mystery. For guys like John, it just comes with the territory.
A lot of people, when I tell them this UFO story, first thing they do is they joke around. And they say, oh, did they probe you? I said, no, I almost probed them, though. You know, they took off, I didn't.